No problem. Just wanted to get a quick shot of that edge.
No, that's fine. I just didn't want to get in your picture.
It's almost got your nose at the edge, right?
Away from this for a month.
It's a ravine. There's some pretty steep sides to it.
Right. It just rolls around. Yeah, unfortunately, there just gets to be too much motion, and there's nothing you can do except slow down the rate.
Get rid of that, that's gonna have some problems there. It's gonna be a little spacer. They use that space, that slide back and forth, that, they're gonna get that lateral.
Yeah, definitely. Yes, it looks like it.
We win.
Here's the end of the coal bunkers.
Hey, Sam, I want to know what your original railroad station is.
Do you have anywhere down there where you actually could do that if you had the money?
That was the coal mix.
So we've cleared right the here, rail line along our property as a rail
the
trail.
Section is, where the kind of like
I know of one farmer,
there would have been a track of property all is, the way up here.
Intersected by the railroad.
Yeah, so the pole,
I can't tell you where exactly it is, but it's where the beach bottom is.
Oh, it's the railroad.
There's one close farmer. You can still see where the right of way went.
Yeah, it's amazing how much of it you can find if you know where to look.
Yeah.
Unlike so many places that are recently abandoned where you can just, oh gee, that's obvious where, you gotta look for a tree line. Because nobody wanted to plow where the trees were, or the gravel was, and so trees grew up.
I know we replaced some of it, but
there are places where the original rail system could be used on the TV.
Yeah.
If you ever love it.
Yes, it is.
Being a short one, we never really needed to update it. The pictures of this fair in the 40s, he made one or two on the spot. They could have maybe one or two of them.
Gonna get loud here, gentlemen.
Every crossing we've gone over.
It's a safety issue with cars.
But we still have to stop. It's in our time table. We have to stop and make sure somebody's flying before they cross it.
The Federal Railroad Administration changed the rules. Not railroads aren't quite as whistle posts anymore. The issue is down a horn between 10 and 15, 20 seconds before you should draw. Depends on your speed.
Number 6 was named Little Mel. Number 7 was named Snooky.
Uh-oh.
This one was named Mighty Mel. Number 10 was never had a name. Number 10 has two different horns on it. What you can see right now is actually from a Southern Railroad. The one on the other side was used by Penn Central.
Metal's a little weight too. Metal's cool, I like that.
Yeah.
I like the metal.
Yeah, it looks nice. Yeah.